Guard looked like the head waiter. The referee, Andy Van Helleman, working his first game in the Stanley Cup Finals this year, joined by Ron Finn to your left and Bob Hodges to your right, the linesman for Game 3. We look at Bill Smith. His average for this year at 2.75, and if you round it out, okay, 2.76, who's going to argue? Richard Grugier, 2.72, 11 wins, 4 losses. Bill Smith, 13-3. The Islanders have won 7 playoff games in a row. Bill Smith has started 13 straight games, 11 wins and 2 ties. Krotze is at center. Wayne Sutter was on the right wing. Karkiles on the left side. Papin and Morrow, the Islander defense. Papin at the center ice zone. His pass was blocked. Here's a break for Jardine coming in on right wing. Fifth, the first save of the hockey game. Al Field back to the right point. Dumped in front by Hallberg, but right to Gilly. Karkiles moves into center over the Vancouver line. Dropped it to Krotze. It was broken up. Here's Bossy. Shoots Brodeur, the save, and he holds on. Bossy, after Vancouver failed to clear the puck, picked it up and tested Brodeur with a blistering shot.
And Brodeur, Jake, if we get a look at it on the replay, looks back behind him. He thought the puck had gone through him, under his arm, into the net. Bossy, he could have kept coming, but he had his weight shifted. He had to let the shot go. Watch the head of Brodeur. He looked back, didn't see it, knew that he had it trapped on his body somewhere. Mike Bossy, a good opportunity for the Islanders. After Gradin had opened the shots on net with a point-blank shot at Billy Smith.
Wayne Sutter had started at right wing, and then Bossy came out as Al Arbour double shifts and gives Vancouver a look at something a little different in his lineup. It is Krotze with Gillies and Bossy at this moment. Jerry Miner dumped the puck into center for the Canucks, and that's Mike McKillen. The Gillies went off his skates. Helene had trouble picking it up. Now Jerry Miner fed it to the Islander line, but off the stick of Williams. Campbell covering up at center, forces McKillen to go back. Helene comes in to forecheck as McKillen waits back to the goal. Mike McKillen up the left side. That's Gillies with it. Karkiles to Krotze over the Vancouver line. Deep move, but then lost the puck. Picks it up, a backhander. Brodeur the save. He holds on. Bossy was there trying to knock it away from him. Now we get some more of the sticks up after the whistle. Everybody congregating.
It's going to be a long night, Jake. Without any reason, Vancouver come in quickly. The gloves and stick in every Islander face.
And referee Van Helleman is going to clamp down immediately. He is handing out penalties 1:06 into the opening period. So we'll get some penalties here and a break in the action. The score is tied with 18:54 left in the first period. Islanders nothing, the Canucks nothing.
Clark Gillies in the penalty box. He and Dave Williams both get high sticking penalties. The second time the Islanders get shots at Brodeur, it happened twice. This time Andy Van Helleman has waved the participants to the penalty box.
So they're at 5 aside as Brodeur played it around his steps and Goring stepped into him. It is Goring and Tonelli, Harrison and Langevin for the Islanders. That's Gradin turning inside the Vancouver line. Gave it to Smeal. Now to Doug Hallward. Steps is out there, the other Vancouver player, a defenseman. Out of Gradin on the right side, off his stick, and Goring dumps it off the board. Cleared aside by Brodeur to Hallward. Hallward around to Harold Steps. Goring again runs into Steps. The puck went to Smeal. Dan Smeal, right side to Hallward. Hallward at the Islander line, checked by Langevin. Tonelli ran into his teammate, and the puck was brought in offside. So we get a whistle and the faceoff outside the New York Islander blue line. More noise at the Pacific Coliseum tonight than I can remember in any visit here over the 10 seasons in the league.
If you had to combine, or if you could combine all of the noise from 10 years, I think it would not be superseded by the noise we hear in here tonight. Actually, I like it, Jake. It's a spirit, a new spirit that we haven't seen, as we mentioned before. And it sounds good. Like to see the people having a good time.
That was Papin giving the puck to Lane, to Kaller off his stick. Lindgren has it at center ice. Lindgren to Campbell, couldn't make contact with it. Papin sent it off to Bourne, who's over the line, trying to come in around Lindgren, but Campbell covers up neatly. Colin Campbell started his career here in the World Hockey Association at that time, and Poppin takes him out with a hip check. Kenny Poppin, unable to clear it. Campbell dumps it back in on a delayed offside, and as Goldereff picks it up now, the play is called. 49 seconds left of the penalties for Williams and Gillies. 2 minutes and 17 seconds gone in this opening period. Something in the crowd has attracted the attention of referee Van Hellen, but it may be a light, probably. Yeah, I think it is a television light that is on. We get a look at Denny Poppin putting the hip check on Campbell.
Open ice. We call that open ice. It's close to the board, but the reason we call it open ice is because he did not use the board as part of the check. He hit Campbell. Campbell upended right near the board. Good hip check by Dennis Poppin. He's been doing that a little more regularly, Jake. That's a good sign for Islander people, management in particular, because that's generally a sign that Dennis Poppin, his concentration is good, and he's back into the hockey game.
Neat move there by McEwen to feed the puck to Trottier. Over the Vancouver line, gave it to Bossy. They're calling it offside. Trottier and Bossy on that pattern play as they come to the blue line. The linesman Ron Finn said they were offside. Trottier disagrees, but it'll matter not.
Well, we have a moment, Jake. The off-ice officials you mentioned from Los Angeles. The official timer, Bill Muris. Official scorer is John Johnson. Penalty timer, Ron Van Gompel. Goal judge, Ed Lee. The other goal judge is Ernie Ruck. Nice to have them. Nice to see them again.
That crew has worked together for many, many years. Bossy with a shot. Off the backboards and off the mesh as well. There's Gradin for Vancouver. Bennett rink wide, a dangerous play, and McEwen cleared to the center, right to Sepp. Harold Sepp from the point, Christmas save. Bache steps in front of Sepp from Spiel, feeds it to the blue line. Here's Hallward on the right side. Bache ran into him. Now Spiel in the corner. The Sepp, Sepp back to him, Sepp Gradin, a weak shot and wide of the goal. He has Smith falling, he was at his mercy, but he couldn't find the open area. Teams at six aside again as Boro carries it to center over the Vancouver line. Boro's shot off the stick of Brodeur. Here's Steps in the corner being tied up now by Gillies, and Tiger Williams controls the puck. Williams down the left wing across the Islander line. Gave it to Fraser. The whistle sounds on the left side. Boy, they're calling them close at either end of the
game. They have to in a game like this. The other thing you have to think about, Jiggs, is that with all of this hype, we'll come back to that when we come back after this message. A break in the action and no score here at the Pacific Coliseum.
16:35 left in the opening period. Wayne Sutter, Brent Sutter, and Clark Gillies for the Islanders now. Brent Sutter dumped it into the Vancouver zone, and that's Gillies in after, and he was knocked down on the play by Edelbrink, and the puck ends up in the control of the Vancouver Canucks. Lars Lindgren fires it around the boards in the Islanders zone, cut off by Smith. Smith played it to the corner. Fraser was there, bumped immediately by Brent Sutter. Comes out in front, cleared by Pearson. And Brent Sutter steps into nil. Long shot from the point, steered aside. And Gillies backhands it out into center ice. Lindgren fed it over to Edelbrink. Edelbrink, the Vancouver defenseman, to Fraser. Comes to the blue line, gave the pass to Boldarev around one man, and then was checked by Brent Sutter. Out comes Pearson to John Cinelli on left wing. Cinelli across the Vancouver line was checked. Fraser picks up the loose puck and banks it off the boards right to Cinelli, who fired one wide. Edelbrink controls it in the right wing corner. Edelbrink, long pass out of the reach of everybody into the Islander zone. Boldarev slaps at it, and that'll be an offside against Vancouver.
The point I was trying to make a moment ago before we went away, Jake, is that in a game like this with so much hype, it's easy for the players to tire themselves early in the game. They get out for the first shift. There's so much hype in the game that they put all of their energies into thinking, and their muscles tighten up. There's the way to tighten them up real good. As you look at Wayne Sutter on a heavy hit a moment ago, he did not get all of the player he was after. But the muscles are up tight, and everything there was not that free-flowing momentum that you like to have, and it's very tiring. It'll take two or three shifts apiece before they relax and get a free flow.
It is Goring with Cinelli and Nystrom for the Islanders. Knucks have dumped it into the Islanders zone, and there's Nystrom around the Poppin. Poppin chased back in the net by Spiel. The puck was loose. Darcy Rota unable to feed it to Spiel. And Gord Lang takes over for the Islanders. Out of Nystrom, but dumps it into center ice. And the Canucks feed one back into their own zone. Hlinka is back in the lineup for Vancouver tonight. Harold Steps played it out of the reach of Steele, and here's Goring taking it offside at the Vancouver blue line.
Ivan Holinka, Czechoslovakian, Slovak, I am called. He's Slovakian. That is not. Yes, it is. That's Steele.
That's Steele.
Me. Holinka is a center iceman. 6 foot two, 31 years old, 219 pounds. He was obtained from Winnipeg, signed by Vancouver, July 1981.
Out is Merrick with Billy Carroll and Anders Kaller for the Islanders. No score in the first period as Lane cleared it to the Vancouver line. Belland was checked there and Steps backing in, feeds it up the right side to Steele. Put it right on the stick of Anders Kaller. Kaller away from one check over to Wayne Merrick. Merrick's long shot was wide of the Canuck goal. Belland chases it back of the net. At this right wing side, right to Poffin. Kenny Poffin trying to get around a check. Lost control of it, but Billy Carroll was there. Out of Lane. Lane being forechecked as he banked it off the glass into center ice. And the Canucks play it back inside their own zone. This is Harold Steps over to Bellin. Mike Bellin back of the net, stolen by Billy Carroll. Carroll taken out by Steps. Now Kaller comes in along with Holinka, and the puck is still loose. Bellin has it. Bellin up the right wing to Lars Bolin. Into center ice, offload is picked and cleared by Morrow for Billy Carroll. Carroll, Kaller, and Merrick as they dump it into the Vancouver zone. Brodeur comes out to cut it off. Gauthier comes out on the ice along with Bossy and Bourne for the Islanders. Lindgren set it up the left side over the Islander line. Bolin taken to the corner by Gauthier. The puck still loose, they rule. You hear Billy Smith yelling at Brian Trottier that it's in his feet. We'll get a face-off to the right on the Islander goal. There's some more New York Islander news today. Well, there's a lot of different areas creating news. The farm team, but more important perhaps for the Islander fans, the kid of the future, the blonde-haired young man who has been a great, great prospect at training camp, was today named the junior hockey player of all of Canada. I refer to Dave Simpson of the London Knights, who was drafted by the Islanders 2 seasons ago. The best junior hockey player in Canada.
That gives a lot more strength to the Islanders system. They have the adult team, the Islanders, of course. They have the Central Hockey League, Indianapolis Checkers, and the International Hockey League team, all competing for the championship.
Now McEwen fed Bourne the puck. Trache back to Bourne. He's across the line, as you see, cutting to the right side, then was checked at the last second. Dean unable to hold it. Williams with a shot off the stick hand glove of Bill Smith, and McEwen will take over. Mike McEwen, then it to Bossy, to Kenny Morrow, now to Bourne. Trache with him on the far side as Bourne comes in over the line. Can't get around Lindgren, and Brodeur came out of the net to clear it. Bourne was grabbed by Lindgren, but the Canucks able to clear it to the line off Williams. Lindgren picks it up. He's roughed up a little bit by Trache, and then Brian was knocked down. Here's Bourne turning. Gave the puck to Bossy. Bossy over the line. Trying to come in around Campbell. Was chased to the corner. Bossy centers, and it comes all the way up to center ice. Back inside his own blue line. Pearson gave it to Gillies. He was checked. In comes Gradin on the right wing side. Put on the break. Shoots. Chris the save, and he covers up. There's Pearson with it now. To Langevin. Langevin to Gillies. Mark Gillies to the Vancouver line is taken out of the play, and Hallward races down the left side. Hallward across the line, trying to cut to the right, gave it to Bolderev, it's on a fly. Jim Dill out for Vancouver. Wayne Sutter fed it to Gillies at center ice. With Trent Sutter, steps back, Gillies' shot, Pitts got a piece of it. Harold Steps bumped back in the goal by Trent Sutter. Now Sutter steps into Frazier and comes up with the puck. Trent Sutter put it out in front. Gillies was too well covered by Bolderev. Here's Wayne Sutter centering to Brent. Can't get a stick on it, and Steps takes over. Harold Steps has cleared it into center ice. Picked up and brought in over the line by Frazier. Frazier center, stolen by Pearson. Stephen Pearson at center. 12 minutes remaining in the period as he gave the puck to Wayne Sutter. Back to Stephen Pearson. A shot. Brodeur just got a piece of it. Wayne Sutter from back of the goal. Center. Brent Sutter in the backhand is tied up by a couple of Canucks. And they move into center ice, led by Bolderev. Bolderev over the Islander line. Three Islanders back to take care of him as Vancouver was in the middle of the change. Now John Tinelli stick handles across the line. Couldn't get completely around Edelbrink. Gave it to Goring back in the net, and it was knocked away from him. Lane pinching in from the right point. Alenka checked by Nystrom out in front. Tonelli a shot. Brodeur holds on. And again, some pushing and shoving after the whistle. But the Islanders are out shooting Vancouver 5-3 and had some excellent chances for this moment.
The best hockey gigs that we've seen in the 2-plus games so far. Vancouver has changed a great deal in their tactics. They're not doing the clutching and grabbing quite so much. They're skating a little more now. As you see some more hitting in the corner. John Tonelli taking a hit from number 10, Edelbrink. Everybody's hitting hard. They're keeping the sticks down, using the shoulder and the hips. There's the shot by John Tonelli. Good stop by Richard Brodeur. One of the better shots of the period, along with the one Mike Bossy let go earlier, a second shift of the hockey game.
Goring is at center ice. Tonelli on the left, Nystrom on the right for the Islanders. Alenka was there to take the faceoff, and Goring has been waved out, apparently. Upset with linesman Ron Finn, and now referee Van Helleman issues a warning, and Brooks is gone for 10 minutes.
Well, it might be an abuse.
Well, it'll be only a two-minute abuse of officials.
He's going to make them pay, and the team pay, obviously. He wouldn't give them a 10-minute misconduct. It would only be a fine. I could be wrong, but I would think Van Helleman went over to make sure that Butch Goring, as you see him there, did not give too much static to linesman Ron Finn. And he gave too much to Van Helleman, and he waved him. We'll have to wait and see.
He came up with the T. I thought he had gone to the hips originally. Then he came up with the T, indicating a two-minute penalty. Unsportsmanlike conduct. It used to be called abuse of the officials. They had that changed. In fact, we're going to have an official as one of our first intermission guests, one of the Islander fans' favorites, Wally Harris. He's going to tell you why he refereed Game 1 the way he did. Maybe. Don't count on it. So Vancouver is on a power play. They have scored 4 power play goals on 12 chances in this series. Overall in the playoffs, they are 14 of 55. A little better than 25% efficiency compared to 19% in the regular season. So they are holding penalty coming up here against the Vancouver Canucks.
Penalty for Stuart Croce. This is the thing that Vancouver is going to do. They're skating much better, Jake. But you'll notice that every time an Islander goes in like this, now watch, Croce checks him off the puck. Brodeur, I should say, hangs onto him. Brodeur gets the penalty. With the break of the action, no score. We'll be right back. A penalty to Gradin nullifies the power play of Vancouver. Goring was in the box. Unsportsmanlike, Gradin, that's a bad penalty for him to take.
Now Moline is across the line, headed to the right side. Bellin goes in deep, up there by Lane. Potvin is tied up at the side of the Islander net. He and Moline just now separate, and out comes Kaller. And there's Kaller down the right side, working on steps as he comes over the line, put on the brakes, headed in front, just out of the reach of Ford. Here's Potvin on the left board. Had trouble turning and now holds it in. Gave it to Bob Ford. Ford into Kaller. Kaller tried to set up Potvin, but that hit Ivan Boldarev. Boldarev around to the left side for Harold Stepp. Stepp unable to catch up with it. Pearson is there. Now Williams comes over and nearly collided with Harold Stepp. Boldarev is across the Islander line. Checked and taken down. Captain Pearson moves it up left wing for Bob Ford. There's no score in the first period. Here's Clark Gillies at center. Gillies over the Vancouver line, gave it to Potvin, moves right in, checks him behind. Bellin, the rookie, caught up with him. Potvin, off the boards, it comes back to Gillies. Mark Gillies, deep move, but the puck was tipped by Williams, and the Islanders cover up his center ice. Ed Sutter dumps it into the Canuck zone. And now play is called in the center ice area. Gillies and Williams had collided. Gillies got a piece of Williams, and now they're right back in close range. Overcome the two linesmen and referee Van Helleman as well.
Williams had hit Clark Gillies with what looked to be a good body check, a hip check, and it seemed to hurt Gillies. He went back after Williams. He gave him a kind of a shove, not really a chop with his stick. Upset Clark Gillies. He does not upset easy.
Nice story in the New York papers yesterday about Clark Gillies and the stare. A big guy will stare you down, Willie.
And it's for real. We've seen it happen before. When he gets mad, he kind of gives you the idea with the look. And if it goes far enough, then the action. 22 seconds left in the penalty to Goring. A little more than that left in the penalty to Gradin as we watch Dave Langevin lead the rush. Gave the puck to Trottier. Trottier coming in on the right side and out of the feet of Campbell, and then they go to the boards together. Lindgren knocked it loose. Lars Lindgren up the right wing side. This is Jerry Miner at the Islander line. Drop pass. Williams a shot. It hit Langevin. And Williams tried to go back to the net. Got a piece of Bill Smith. Williams about playing the puck. And he was legal game. Now Williams takes a run at Bossy as the Islanders have cleared it to center. Back in the Vancouver zone is Lindgren. Islanders with a brief power play, and now it is over. The teams at six aside, and Bourne took the pass but offside at the Vancouver line. 8:57 remaining in the opening period. A break in the action. The score is tied. The Islanders nothing, the Canucks nothing. We watch Ivan Hlinka move in for the faceoff, and Butch Goring is again moved out by linesman Ron Finn. Hlinka got the draw into his own zone. Campbell fed it over to Lindgren. Lars Lindgren from center, banks it around the board, cut off by Smith, picked up by Morrow. To the right side, Nystrom and Smeal stepped in front of him. Here's Rota with it. Put it out in front. Hlinka's shot went wide. And cut on the left wing side and out of the reach of John Tinelli. So the Canucks at center ice feed it off the boards, but right to McEwen. He's checked. Hlinka moves in, shoots, Smith the save. He got in front of the rebound. What a save off Smeal after Hlinka had had the first opportunity. Smith appeared to be handcuffed 18.
I was worried that Billy Smith might be dividing his attention, Jake, between some of the physical actions and stopping the puck. But watch here as Hlinka fights off McEwen. Point blank, stopped by Smith. Rebound, another beautiful save. Billy Smith standing up, challenging the shooters. As we look again at Hlinka getting away from Mike McEwen. What a save there by Smith. The rebound, he grapples in, hangs on. Fine move, two fine saves by Billy Smith.
That's been the save of the hockey game, maybe the series to this point. So the Islanders starting out of their own zone now. Nystrom to Goring. Goring into center ice, backhanded it to the Vancouver territory. Lindgren trying to go back in the net. Set it up the right side. Off the boards, and it comes to center ice. McEwen tipped it over to Goring. Goring away from Hlinka, just dumped it over the line, and Lindgren feeds it back into center ice. This is Mike McEwen to John Tinelli. Tinelli, rink wide for Nystrom, across the line, working on Campbell. Nystrom dropped it for Goring, plays one back of the goal. Brodeur comes out to feed it to the corner. That's Nystrom to Tinelli, in front to Goring. Goring turning, had to go to the far side. Out to Nystrom. Nystrom trying to get in around the check of Hallward, and the shot was cut off and cleared by Hlinka. McEwen comes back to the Islander defense. Cleared it to the Vancouver line. Hallward sends Hlinka over the line, but he failed to wait for Spiel to get back onside. So we have 7:34 remaining in this opening period.
A lot of people wondering why Butch Goring did not shoot the puck when he had it in the position he had it in a moment ago, Jake. And the reason he didn't was, one, the puck was in behind him. Maybe we'll see it here on the play. No more hitting as Spiel takes John Tinelli into the board. The reason Goring didn't shoot, the puck was behind him. He was off balance. He couldn't get a good shot away. And he opted to hang on and try and set up Bob Nystrom.
Now we watch Lane feed it around to the far side, and that's Brent Sutter carrying it to center. Brent Sutter dances his way over the Vancouver line, fed it to the left wing, but out of the reach of Gillies, and it's cleared back for Poffin. To Lane, toward Lane, into center ice, but across two lines as Brent Sutter was coming back, but didn't get there in time. I want to send along our best wishes for a very good Islander fan who's recovering after a stint in the hospital. Betty Orfoto is back home now, Bob's wife, and we wish her well.
A different look for the Vancouver Canucks in their home uniform.
And like you pointed out earlier, these two teams, a little better brand of hockey tonight. Here's a break as Gradin moves in, and Smith came out to knock it away from him. Came right through in front of the net, but the play has been called, and we'll get a penalty against Lord Lane. Lane trying to catch up with Gradin, but he'll take the penalty here. A break in the action. The score tied. Islanders nothing, the Canucks nothing. A
penalty to Gord Lane, a hooking penalty on Gradin. There's the puck that went right across in front of the net. Close call as Lane draws a penalty. And Vancouver gets another power play advantage. The last time they had a power play advantage with Goring in the box, Gradin took a holding penalty to nullify it only a few seconds into the power play. Killing it off, Trache and Goring up front. The Canucks held it in the line, and Hallward has dumped it back of the goal. Gradin checked by Langevin, and Pearson feeds it to Trache. Out to center, Goring with Moline back. Trache broke his stick. So Goring comes in with a drive, blocked by Brodeur, and the rebound cleared in the nick of time for Bolderev. Ivan Bolderev chased back into his own zone by Carroll. Bolderev to the left side as the Canucks set up in the power play. Came right back to Bolderev. Dropped it for Lars Moline, and he has to turn at center right. Moline shoots it in wide of Bill Smith. Came off the board. Pearson cleared it to the corner. Moline lost his balance, and Pearson picks up the puck. Stefan Pearson up the right side. Billy Carroll breaks out with Bourne. One man back. That's Bellin. Here's Carroll coming in on right wing. Right in, and Bellin falling was able to cut off the pass and send it for Bourne.
Fine play by young Bellin. A two-on-one break, and the Islanders do not get a shot on net.
Now Bob Bourne picks up a loose puck. Tries to cut in front, but a penalty against Billy Carroll will nullify that chance. The Islanders will be two men short. They're calling Billy Carroll, who was in checking, took the man down, granted, but apparently did it illegally, and with 1 minute left in Lane's penalty, the Islanders are in a bit of a problem situation now.
Billy Carroll upset with himself. Here's how it happened. You see the loose hand. He's got his stick in his right hand. He reached out with the left. That's twice he did it. You see Andy Van Helleman in the back of the picture as we look again at the two-on-one break. Look at Bellin. Bob Bourne was in. Billy Carroll tries to get the puck to him. Bellin sliding out, making the save off the pass, breaking up the play. Two men short now, the Islanders. Lane went in for hooking, and now Billy Carroll gets a holding penalty. There is 1 minute left on Lane's penalty. 5:57 remaining here in the first period. No score.
That play by Bellin reminded me of another guy that came out of that same town in Ontario. Harry Sound, the town that produced Bobby Orr. So we watch the Canucks with a two-man advantage. Edelbrink shot it around the boards. Bill Smith cuts it off back of the net, played it to the corner, but right to Rota. Darcy Rota to Steele. Steele from the right point, shoots one, it was wide of the target. In comes Hallward. Bortle steps into him. The puck sprung loose. Palenka comes out in front of backhander. Fifth the save. Blocked the rebound. A scramble. It's loose. Here's Rota with it.
Billy Smith without a stick.
Rota from the corner to the blue line. Edelbrink from the right point now. Edelbrink, good shot. Fifth the save. And Goring backhands it out of there. 18 seconds left in the penalty to Lane. That's the first of the two against the Islanders. Big Hlinka line makes it Hallward, rather, across the Islander line. Hallward got it to Hlinka. Shoots, fits the save. The rebound is under Poffan. Picked up by Bourne, but a hand pass is called. Poffan thought about falling on it, then pushed it ahead to Bourne. The penalty against Lane is just over. 1 minute left in the penalty to Billy Carroll.
You see the perspiration on the face of Andy Van Helleman as he calls the game. He is pumped up for a big hockey game, as well as the players.
And you're well, getting a view from where we're watching the game from.
Looking down at the pigeons. It's a good view, no complaint. Dennis Potvin, quickly, his second thoughts were he was down on the puck and he was eligible to get a delay of the game penalty. He moved the puck with his hand out from underneath him. Bob Bourne took the pass. And that's a hand pass stopping the play.
Now Trache has dumped it down into the Vancouver zone. Moline chasing it. The Islanders, two men short for a minute. Killed that off, and now they're one man short. No score in the first period. Canucks have dumped one into the corner. Williams in quickly. Poffan tied him up. Here's Bolderev with it. Went to center, one to Williams, and it was broken up by Goring. Poffan to the right wing for Trache. Backhanded and outside the blue line, picked up by Williams.
Good feeling for the defenseman, in this case, Potvin, Jiggs, as he was able to just bounce it off the boards without looking. He knew Trache was supposed to be there.
Now Williams, bumped by Potvin as he dumps it deep in the Islander zone. There's Morrow with it. Off the boards and right to Williams.
Dave Tiger Williams being chased to the corner by Morrow. Then his check taken off the puck, and Goring clears it, not out. This time, Belland unable to make the move, and Popham moves into center, pokes it into the Vancouver zone. That's Kaller chasing it. Anders Kaller taken out by Belland's check. Radin comes out of the corner. Billy Carroll comes out of the penalty box, teams at six aside. Lars Lindgren to Boldarev as he comes over the blue line. Ivan Boldarev, right wing to Fraser. Kurt Fraser dumps it back of the net. It'll be picked up by Persson. Stefan Persson to Anders Kaller. Kaller to Carroll. He couldn't clear it out over the line. Now, Anders Kaller got it into the center ice zone, and it's shot right back in for Langevin. Langevin to Bossy, went off his stick. Mike Bossy pokes it ahead to Gillies. Unable to pick it up, Bossy took it away from Fraser, then lost it. Carroll steps to this right side for Lars Lindgren. The step. Steps just dumped it into center ice. That's Persson back to Langevin. Left side to Clark Gillies. Gillies pass, and Jennifer Trache was deflected. Picked up by Ron DeLorme. The loophole, the fans yelling Lou. Loophole dumps it into the Islander zone and went right to Langevin. Langevin to Gillies, relayed it out of the reach of Trache. Here's Harold Steps. Back into the Vancouver zone. The Canucks gave it to Lupo. Now to Snepp. A little less than 3 minutes to play in the period. Long pass to Fraser as across two lines. We'll get a face-off just inside the Vancouver territory. The Canucks have had three power play opportunities. Granted, one of them was very brief, only 19 seconds in length. The Islanders limited to only a 19-second man advantage. That following the penalties to Goring and then Grandin back at 8:41 of this opening period. In this playoff year, the Islanders with 13 wins, two away from their third consecutive Stanley Cup. Eight of the wins have come at home, five have been on the road. It's Wayne Merrick, John Cinelli, and Bob Nystrom up front. Morrow and McEwen on defense. Ivan Hlinka on the faceoff for Vancouver, got it back to Campbell. Played it out of the reach of Rota, and that's Morrow picking it up inside the Islander line. Now to McEwen. Mike McEwen, rink wide, off the stick of Hlinka. Wayne Merrick fires one wide of the Vancouver goal. In comes John Tinelli. Tinelli off the left wing side, put it in front, back to Morrow. Morrow shot to a screen, went wide. It's loose and cleared. There's going to be a penalty coming up. The Vancouver Canucks. Rota took the puck to the boards. Now play is called. Nystrom had been dragged down in the goal mouth. And Vancouver draws a holding penalty, setting up a power play for the Islanders with 2:23 left in the first period. It'll be Campbell, the veteran defenseman, getting the gate. Colin Campbell for holding at 17:37. We can take another look at it. There's Nystrom as he goes down at the side of the net, being held by Campbell. Ed Westfall is headed downstairs. He'll be talking with Clark Gillies at the end of his first intermission. At the end of the first period, I should say. Our other guest will be Wally Harris, referee game one of this series. And the game or the work of Mr. Harris roundly criticized. We saw another look. Holding penalty to Campbell at 17:37. So the Islanders have been vicious on the power play. Persson, the Popham. Over to Persson. Stefan Persson takes a shot. Brodeur the save. And it's lodged in his hand. Not a fluke. I say vicious, I mean they've taken advantage of almost every opportunity. 6 of 10, 60% efficiency rating coming into this game three. That is Roger Nielsen, former head coach of the Toronto Maple Leafs, former head coach of the Buffalo Sabres, the associate coach up until March 20th. That's when the suspension was levied on the Vancouver coach, Harry Neal. And Roger took over. Team did not lose another game. Went to the playoffs and all the way to the cup finals. Here's Popham with a shot that was blocked. Bossy plays it back of the goal to Gillies to Trache. Ryan Trache off the board to Popham at the point. Into Bossy, who had trouble picking it up. Lindgren dumps it around the board. Here's Gillies on his off wing. Gillies to Trache. Out in front to Gillies to the blue line and away from Stefan Persson. Persson backs into center ice. Dumps it to the Vancouver line. It was knocked down and cleared by Lindgren. So a minute 10 remaining in the Islander power play as Persson starts up. Stefan Persson got it to the Vancouver line, came right back to Poffin, to Trotsche, now over to Bossy, but he couldn't pick it up. Bob Bourne comes in off the right point. Bourne being chased by Steph to the blue line to Persson, and off his stick, he'll pick it up at center ice, giving it to Poffin. Poffin trying to slip it through to Bourne, and that was broken up. Jim Mills for Vancouver forces the Islanders back with 44 seconds remaining in the man advantage. Poffin and Persson got crossed up back of the net, and then he got his stick jammed in the doorway. Feeds the puck to Bourne. Bourne with a minute left in the period. Tried to dump one in that hit Edelbrink. Picked up by McEwen. McEwen slaps it around the boards. It got away from Brodeur. Here's Bourne on the left side. Into the corner to Trotsche. Trotsche to Bossy. Bossy out of the corner to the blue line to McEwen. A drive. Brodeur the save. Bourne the rebound. Brodeur robbed it. Brodeur just robbed Bob Bourne on the rebound. 10 seconds left in the power play as McEwen moves back in on the right side. McEwen put it out in front, but was picked up and fired the length of the ice by Jim Neal. That kills off the penalty against Campbell. The team back at 6 aside. No score. Oh, Dwayne Sutter's pass was broken up, and the Canucks couldn't hold it as Lupo made a good play. Now McEwen feeds it to Goring. Goring with 10 seconds left in the period. Fired it wide at the Canuck goal. Dwayne Sutter trying to put it out in front. Did, but it was cut off. And the Canucks move it into center ice. Here's Lupo across the blue line. Lupo, the miner, he shoots, but the buzzer beat him. He missed the target anyway, but the period has come to a close. The Islanders now shooting Vancouver by a margin of 9-8 in the opening period. Canucks with a couple of great opportunities. They had a two-man advantage for a full 60 seconds and couldn't capitalize. The Islanders, on the other hand, had the early chances, had some chances again late in the period, especially with Campbell off for holding at 17 home. Tickets are on sale at the Coliseum box office and Ticketron outlets. All seats are $30. The place here, the Vancouver Coliseum, the Pacific Coliseum, a buzz between periods coming up from where I had interviewed Clark Gillies. Everybody was a buzz with the fact that it was a great period, one of the fine periods that we've seen in the playoffs. No question, the best period we've seen in seven between the Islanders and the Vancouver Canucks. And now we are set for period two. Brian Trotsche centering for Dwayne Sutter and Bob Bourne. On defense, it'll be McEwen and Morrow. Goaltender Richard Brodeur is now getting ready. Ed pointed out that the off-ice officials are from Los Angeles, and we know that several of the wives are gathered together there tonight, wives of the off-ice officials, watching this game on Channel 9, WOR. That's Harold Stepps back to the Vancouver goal. Trotsche trying to ride him off the puck. Stepps cleared it down into the Islander zone, and as McEwen touches up, we get an icing call. Interesting reading in the Vancouver Sun today. The Canucks say that Trotsche picks on the little guys. He never takes on any of the big Canucks. He only goes after little people.
Did they really say that?
They really said that. It's hard to believe. I don't know what game they were watching. And they had a lot of things to say about Billy Smith. And the guy they really picked on was Dwayne Sutter. But that's, you have to remember, that's coming from the mouths of people like Tiger Williams.
Boy, he has had a lot to say, hasn't he? Oh. Quoted everywhere in the New York papers. I didn't get a chance to read them here. Just got off the plane and came to the game.
I hope you showered.
Yes.
Oh, good.
Steps
up the right side to center and down into the Islanders' zone. McEwen turned looking for the referee and taking the feet out from under Moline. But there's no penalty, and the faceoff will be to the right of goaltender Richard Brodeur. There is a look at the man that Wally Harris said could clutch and grab with the best of them when he was the Toronto Maple Leaf.
Radar.
The story, the old story true about Carl Brewer cutting the palms out of his gloves,
no,
whipping his fingers back out of his fingers and grabbing your stick.
You're right, and he had them right into the rule book that you had to have palms in the gloves, in your hockey gloves. He used to reach through his cut out palms, grab a hold of the stick. It looked like he didn't, because the referee or the officials thought his fingers were in the right places, but actually they weren't. And he used to grab a hold of sweaters and sticks and people. And there was a time when Carl Brewer was quite a hockey player. When he first came out of junior hockey from the Toronto Marlboros, and into the National Hockey League. He was one of the fine rookies and continued to play fine hockey for a number of years. Vaughn, Brewer, Stanley, Arbor, the rest of them in the Toronto Maple Leafs defense of that era.
Puffhead up the left side to Bourne, across the line, can't get around Howard. Now Bob Bourne taken into the boards. Boring is tipped it to Nystrom. Betts runs into him. And the Canucks dump it out into center ice. Williams chasing it into the Islanders' zone, but Lane gets back. Over to Poffin. Kenny Poffin to Bob Bourne. Back to Poffin. Poffin to Lane on this right side. Gordy Lane shoots it into the Vancouver zone. It got away from Brodeur. But the Canucks able to clear it up the left side. Miner to Williams. Kept in by Lane to John Cinelli. Cinelli shot through a screen. Grabbed by Brodeur. Nystrom slaps at it. It's underneath Richard Brodeur. And Brodeur comes up swinging the stick at Nystrom. That's to be expected with Nystrom trying to bat the puck away from him. And again, a lot of discussion in front of what is now the Vancouver goal.
Something close. Bob Nystrom coming close. He's down on the ice. The puck is loose. The puck is available. The whistle has not blown. And Bob Nystrom tries his best to put it in behind Richard Brodeur. Richard Brodeur does a lot of skating around from his net. I don't know whether it's nervous habit or what, but he does a great deal of skating away from his net during the stoppages of play.
Brodeur, former Islander, came to Vancouver in a straight exchange of fifth-round draft choices last summer, and the player the Islanders acquired, Jacques Silvestri. And I said the other night on a home game that nobody knew much about Jacques Silvestri. Well, he was just named to the second All-Star team in the Quebec Junior League. So he is definitely a prospect. Cinelli put it off to the side of the Canuck goal, and it comes to the left side. Out into center ice to Rota. Archie Rota across the line. Stops, makes the play, and is steered aside by Bill Smith. Buffan takes his man. Smith cleared it to the corner. Big Hlinka trying to come out in front with a backhander. Cut off by Poffin, and there's Gord Lane with it. Lane around the board. Spiel picks it up. Poffin got a piece of him. Spiel back and escapes. He and Rota behind the net together. Hlinka goes out in front of the goal, but now they freeze it for a faceoff.
Good pursuit of the puck and the Islander players by Vancouver here early in the second period. No score.
Again, we look at Roger Nielsen. You will see an awful lot of the two coaches as you watch this series with us on Channel 9. Nielsen's team down 2-0. Al Arbor up 2-0. And the expression just about the same. All serious. Bache on the draw. Canucks got the puck. Fraser shot off the stick of Pearson. Stefan Pearson to Brent Sutter, out into the center ice zone. Trache unable to pick it up. Trache, Gillies, and Brent Sutter. Now Trache is replaced by Dwayne Sutter as the Islanders have to go back for it. Smith couldn't play it away from Fraser. Fraser centers, and it was hit by Gillies and down into the Vancouver zone. Harold Stepp comes after it. Gillies in on the far side. Stepp played it to the near wing. Ivan Boldarev to Fraser. Fraser and Gradin come to center ice together. Fraser over the line with a long shot. Smith got the stick hand in front of that. And Langevin dumps it around behind the net. This is Wayne Sutter. Back to Pearson. Over to Langevin. Langevin out into center ice for Brent Sutter. Sutter shoots it off the board to the Canucks' zone. Brodeur gathers it in back of the net. Played it right to Brent Sutter in front to Gillies. He scores! Brent Gillies from Brent Sutter. The Canucks. The goaltender in particular, Gilly, is giving the puck away in his own end of the ice, and typical Islander fashion, they jump on it for a 1-0 lead.
Clark Gilly, his eighth goal. Let's take a look. There's Brodeur. He passed it right to Sutter. Sutter to Gilly, and Gilly puts it in the open side of the net. Let's look again as Sutter gets it to Gilly, and Brodeur moving to his right. He was guessing, and Gilly gets his eighth goal of the playoffs. And makes the score 1-0 for the New York Islanders.
2:56, the time of the goal. We're in period two here in Vancouver. Jake McDonald with Ed Westfall. Back for the Islanders, Mike McEwen. Off the board, Canucks stole it, put it down in front. Miner was turned around, it's in his skate.
Can't get a stick on it. Bossy chases it to the board. Flips it high in the air. Out into center ice. It drops right at the skates of Trottier, who comes in over the line. Ryan Trottier. Trying to get away from the check of Lindgren. Trottier got it to the corner. Bourne is bumped there by Campbell. And now Williams taken out of the play by Bossy. And Williams gives Bossy an elbow. McKillen in from the left point. Made it around behind the net. Williams and Campbell converge on Bossy. Now Trottier given a bump by Miner as he dumps it through in front. Here's Mike McKillen with a shot. Grab by Brodeur, and he'll hold it for a face-off. Bang, bang as Campbell and Williams went after Bossy a few moments ago.
They're not going to get to Mike Bossy, Jake. In the past, he's shown it time and time again in the last 3 or 4 years in particular that if they go after him, the way he beats them is by scoring goals. He can sidestep. I often describe Mike Bossy as a Nureyev on ice. He has great strength, great balance, great flexibility, and he has a tremendous knack of being able to avoid players like Dave Williams who rush at him trying to take him out of the play. He'll take a hit, and every now and then he'll give one back.
So it is 1-0 Islanders as play gets underway. Rota lost it in his own zone. Tinelli trying to center. Goring comes in to pick it up. Butch Goring out in front to Nystrom, who had to shoot it wide. He was being rushed in front of the net. Now Hlinka around to Smeal. Hooks it out into center ice, but Gord Lane is there. That's Rota moving up on Lane. Gordy Lane banks one off the glass into the Vancouver zone. Lindgren chases it. And we get an icing call against the New York Islanders. So the faceoff moves all the way back into the Islanders zone as we get a good look at Butch Goring.
A whirling dervish.
And here's another look at the Islander goal as Brodeur played it right to Brent Sutter to Gillies. And at 2:56 in the second period, it is 1-0 Islanders.
Richard Brodeur does not handle the puck well, Jake. He has trouble. He seems to shift the stick in his hands like he was a right-hand shot, and he wanted to shift it over, or a left-hand shot, and he wants to shift it over to his right when he shoots the puck.
Out is Lane playing it around to the right-wing boards for Nystrom. Bob Nystrom starts up with Poffin. The Islander captain over the line. Shot one right on target. The big rebound. And Brodeur couldn't handle it, nor could Nystrom. Here's Lane from the point. His shot deflected in front. Nystrom feeds it back to Tinelli. Tinelli runs into step. Now Goring is bumped on the boards. And there is Hlinka. He works it around to the right side for Stan Smeal. Smeal out into center. Over to Steps across the Islander line. Depth went to center, one that hit Lane, and Nystrom picks it up on right wing. Nystrom with Bellin trying to get back. Nystrom shot. Brodeur the save. The rebound. Tinelli shot with off the right post and ended up back of the net. Cleared by Steph to Rota. He tips it into center ice, and Pearson is back. Steph and Pearson to Poffin. Poffin gets over the line, trying to cut through on this right side. Was slowed up and ran into Steph. Poffin recovers the puck. Hit off the boards to Dwayne Sutter, to Brent Sutter. Pulls it away from Bellin. Center, here's Pearson. He shoots, cut off, the rebound. That's blocked, another rebound, and Dwayne Sutter fired it wide. Make it Tinelli, rather. Now Brent Sutter comes out of the corners. The Islanders applying the pressure here. Pearson covered up outside the line and shot it back in offside. And it'll be brought all the way down into the Islanders' zone.
What pressure! The Islanders hold their goal and move the puck. One of the teams that does it best as Brent Sutter comes to life again. That's Tinelli as he moves it in front. In from the point, Stefan Pearson shot. Stopped by Brodeur twice off Pearson. And Brent Sutter across the goal mouth to Dwayne Sutter, and he almost knocked it out of the air right there. It's Tinelli, I'm sorry. Excuse me. With John Tinelli, who come close to picking the puck out of the air in the open side.
14:27 left in the second period as Fraser digs it off the boards, got it to Boldarev. He played it around behind the Islander goal and overcame Gillies. Now Smith up to into the corner. Fraser is there. Langevin bumps into him and they pile up on the puck. There is a break in the action with 14:10 left in period two. Our score, the Islanders 1, the Canucks no score. We take a look at the two goaltenders. They have played
Well, in the case of Brodeur, every game for Vancouver, Bill Smith has played every game but one in the playoffs for the New York Islanders.
27 out of 28 playoff games Billy Smith has played in for the Islanders. Not this year, it goes back to last year.
Langevin trying to move it up the right side. Brent Sutter has it tied up in his skates and it's sprung loose to the left wing for Hercules. Dumped it into center ice. Fraser handed it right to Trotche. Back quickly comes Lindgren. Lars Lindgren to Boldarev. Ivan Boldarev across the line. Langevin got a piece of him. Boldarev skirts the check, put it off to the side of the net, and it was cut off by Smith. Now to Dwayne Sutter. He clears it to Sutter. Down into the collect zone and right to Brodeur. Edelbrink will pick it up. The Islanders in the middle of the player chain. Edelbrink to Boldarev to Gradin. Thomas Gradin left it for Boldarev. Comes over the Islander line around McEwen with a neat move. And Gillies got a piece of him. And Pearson cleared the puck for McEwen. He dumps it out of there. This time it'll go for an icing call as Lindgren goes back. Chased by Merrick, who forced him to pick up the pace a little bit.
The pressure by Ivan Boldarev and the Vancouver Canucks force the Islanders, Mike McEwen, to ice the puck again. Boldarev got around McEwen. Clark Gillies tucked in behind him. Some of the pattern defensive plays of Al Arbour as the forwards cut behind the defense. If the onrushing forwards get in behind an Islander defenseman, there should be a center iceman or a winger back there to help him out.
Boldarev at the Vancouver bench as Miner has gone to the center ice position. Tiger Williams on the left. You know who's on the right wing for the Islanders automatically. Mike Bossy, along with that man, Brian Trotche, and Bob Bourne is on the left side. 1-0 Islanders. Miner got the draw to Williams to the blue line, and the shot went way wide of the net. Picked up by Bossy, but now play is called. Some pushing and shoving going on, and Trotche and Williams will go to the penalty box. Back in the first period, it was Williams and Gillies. This time, it is the Tiger and Brian Trotche.
The intimidation tactic. There's a break in the action. The score, the New York Islanders won. The Vancouver Canucks, no score.
Billy Carroll with it now. Carroll checked on the boards by Hallward. Got it to Wayne Merrick. Neff runs into him, and Brodeur comes out to play. Gave it to Lars Folin. Folin put it right on Morrow's stick to Merrick. Merrick's centering attempt was deflected. And he picked up by Hallward. Hallward around the boards for Lupul, chased by Mike McEwen. Lupul dumps it the other way, and in comes Kaller. Anders Kaller at the side of the net. In front to Billy Carroll, and the shot was blocked by Brodeur. Carroll very alertly on the puck again to the blue line to McEwen. Mike McEwen fired it to the corner. It was knocked out of the air and picked up by Hallward. Over to the Islander line, over to Lupul. Kaller broke up that play, and back comes Billy Carroll. Three Canucks back quickly. Carroll to Kaller is over the line. His shot was just wide of the stick side. This is Doug Hallward being bothered by Kaller. Hallward gave it to Campbell. Nolan Campbell up the right wing. Neal tries a shot that goes off the stick of Lane and way up into the crowd. 11:50 remaining in period two. 38 seconds left in the penalties to Trotche and Williams.
Good chance for Billy Carroll. As you look at Stan Smeal, number 12 of the Vancouver Canucks. 23-year-old, Glendon, Alberta. Carroll's backhand stopped by Brodeur. Carroll was almost in the goal crease when he let his backhand go.
Well, you really let me down a minute ago, 18.
And the Islanders have just let the Canucks move down the left side. Gradin comes in, shoots, and he fired it wide at Billy Smith. Here is Dan Spiel. Back of the net, Gradin being tied up. Goring gets a stick on it down to Poppin. Kenny Poppin, left side for Tinelli, and Campbell is the lone defenseman back. Tinelli slows up the play a little bit, waiting for Goring. Gave him the puck back to Tinelli. Tinelli's shot was blocked and cleared by Lindgren. Campbell with it at center, Dustin Williams and Trotche have come out of the penalty box. Now Campbell on the left side into the Islanders zone. Plays it to the right wing, but right to Butch Goring. Goring dumps it to center. Lindgren is there. Poppin fires it out of the Islanders zone, then is bowled over by Campbell, and back in over the line come the Canucks. Field fake the shot.
Now back to Campbell, checked from behind by Tinelli, and he feeds it to Trotsche. One man back, it's Hallward. Trotsche over the line, shooting, and it hit Hallward. Bounces to the left wing boards for Williams. Plays it rink wide, out of the reach of Spiel, and Langevin is there. Got it to Trotsche, now to Brent Sutter. Brent Sutter over the line, trying to walk in around Hallward. In back of the net, put it out in front, but the Islanders were in the middle of a player change. Boldarev chased deep by the checking of Brent Sutter. Boldarev around the boards. Here's Gillies coming in. Back to Langevin. A shot from the point right on. Brodeur the save. Brent Sutter with the rebound. Chased to the corner by Steph. The puck is poked loose. Picked up by Neal. Neal to Williams. Williams at the Islander line to Boldarev. Trying to come through around Pearson. Put it on target. It was cleared by Smith to Gillies. Gillies is checked. Comes back to the blue line. Hallward shot. Smith the save. And he'll hold it for a faceoff. And Fraser ran into him. Neal comes in late, and they converge again. A break in the action. 9:58 left in the second period. The score is Islanders 1, Canucks nothing. Well, there they go with the towels again as we're past the midway point of the second period.
I was just kidding when I said you let me down. The gentleman in the crowd, I thought you would know for sure.
They zeroed in on that gentleman. It looked like Dickie Duff. It did. And it turned out to be Bill Bennett, the premier of Quebec.
No, of Alberta.
I mean of Alberta. Well, what they say, Quebec? I'm trying to watch the hockey game, and I can't think politics.
Did I said Alberta and British Columbia. Oh, well, we've got a penalty call coming up here. The Islanders control the puck. Smith goes to the bench. Pearson got it to Trotsche to the side of the net. Cleared, and the whistle sounds. The Islanders get their first power play chance of this second period, a holding penalty with 9:31 left in period two. Hallward goes to the penalty box. Yeah, Vancouver is in the province of British Columbia. The man you saw on your screen is the premier of this province, which would be the same as being the governor of any of the U.S. states.
Trying to watch an exciting hockey game and cover up from the mistake that you made twice. It gets confusing. The next thing you want to do is call one of the hockey players, Bill Bennett. And he'd probably love, he probably does play hockey.
Hey, the Mets beat the Dodgers at Shea Stadium 4-2 tonight.
They what? They did it again, huh?
Yeah.
All right.
Should have had one last night except for the rain.
They get Valenzuela tomorrow night, don't they?
That'll be a good one.
Can we go home to watch?
It'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would.
That'll be right here on Channel 9. Poffin over the far side. McEwen shot. Came off the stick of Brent Sutter. Wayne Sutter goes to the corner. Steps. Lost it to Wayne Sutter. To Gillies. To Brent Sutter. And he shot it wide as he had Brodeur moving to the right side. Here's McEwen from the blue line to Poffin. Poffin back to McEwen. In front to Dwayne Sutter. It went off his stick. Picked up by Miner. Gary Miner comes to center ice. Miner across the Islander line. Gillies got a piece of him. Miner still with the puck, however. Put it right on the stick of McEwen, and he leads the rush at center ice. Mike McEwen across the line. Dwayne Sutter heads in on right wing. McEwen shot blocked by Steps, and Gradin picked up the no puck. Honest Gradin at center over the Islander line. Gradin put on the brakes, centered one, but put it right on the stick of Poffin. Danny Poffin with Bossy to the left. Poffin is across the line. The pass to Pearson. Stefan Pearson fed it to Bourne. A shot from the point off the stick. Brodeur picked up by Trotsche. Trotsche to Bossy. To Trotsche to the blue line. Pearson to Poffin. He shoots. Turned aside by Brodeur. There's Harold Spetz up the left side. And the Canucks to force the Islanders back. 42 seconds left in Hallward's penalty. Pearson to Bossy. Bossy to Pearson. Stefan Pearson across the Vancouver line. Pearson trying to get around Campbell. A neat move to get away from the Vancouver defenseman. Now to Tinelli. Tinelli a drive, and it was just wide. Bossy the rebound. That shot hit Campbell, and Lupo has it to Tinelli. Tinelli to Trotsche. Trotsche trying to move around Lindgren. Lupo is there as well. The puck goes to Bossy. Mike Bossy from back of the net. Out to Pearson. Pearson takes a look, comes back to the point as you see, trying to get away from Spiel. His shot was blocked. Bossy the rebound, a good save by Brodeur. Another shot, they scored! The Islanders on the second rebound. Bossy has put it in the net. The penalty to Hallward had expired, and the Islanders are up 2-0.
With Campbell going into the net, Bossy laying down, Let's take a look at the action. There's the first shot by Mike Bossy. He takes the rebound. Now, how many guys can do that? I have never seen the way that man can put pucks in the net. Mike Bossy, as he's falling to the ice, a backhand shot, no less. Watch it right here. There's Bossy going down, and he still puts the puck by Brodeur, and he puts it by Colin Campbell, who fell into the net with a desperate move, trying to keep Bossy's backhand shot out. He is unsuccessful, and the New York Islanders have taken a 2-0 lead. 15th goal of the playoffs for Mike Bossy.
And five of those 15 have come in this final series against the Vancouver Canucks. So the Islanders are up 2-0, and it's Goring going back to the Islanders. Morrow will go off for interference as he steps in front of Stan Steele, and the Canucks will get a power play chance. Morrow for interference. There is a break in the action. The score, the Islanders 2, the Vancouver Canucks no score. There's the penalty that Ken Morrow has just received, an interference call. Here's the goal, Mike Bossy's backhand, and then falling down, he let it go again. Amazing, Mike Bossy.
You cannot practice that kind of scoring, Jake. Michael Bossy has it. We've said that so many times, and it is true. You can't practice putting pucks into the net when you're falling down on your backhand. That's imagination, and it's strength.
And it came 1 second after the penalty to Hallward had expired. But now Morrow is off, and the Canucks on a power play. Goring just took the link of down, and the fans are really upset with referee Van Halen.
The Islanders had a break there, Jake. Had they not been already a man short, I'm sure Van Halen would have called that penalty on Butch Goring.
Well, he made the Islanders two men short at one point in the first period. Over Lookman as Halenka fires a long shot right into the catching glove of Bill Smith. He gave it to Poppan. DeBorn out to Kaller, and he's got a breakaway. Anders Kaller coming in on Brodeur. Kaller shifts, shoots. Brodeur got a piece of it.
I can't believe that Ivan Halenka didn't even try to get to Andy Kaller. He just couldn't watch them.
Now Bourne took it away from Rota, comes over the Vancouver line. He has taken off the puck and out of the play, and that's Hallward with it. Doug Hallward up the right side for Boldarev. Stick handles over the Islander line. Boldarev to Fraser. He shoots, fits the save. Big rebound. That'll break a shot to a screen, and it was high and wide. Boldarev plays it around to Lindgren. Lars Lindgren back of the goal to Boldarev. Out in front. That'll break the shot. Good save by Smith. It was out at the side of the net. Bob Bourne whacking at it. Can't clear it out. The Canucks clear it out themselves, and Lindgren comes back into center ice. 20 seconds left of the penalty to Morrow. Knocks down 2-0 as they dumped it in wide of Smith. That's scoring. He is double-teamed. Pearson tried the puck loose to Poppan, and he'll backhand it to center right. 8 seconds remaining in the Canuck power play. Long pass up the middle, stolen by Goring. Goring to the Vancouver line. Ran into Lindgren. Morrow is back on. Here's Fraser with it. Shot it off the board. Goring with it at the Islander blue line. Clears it to center. That's Boldarev coming back. Ivan Boldarev. Neat shift to get away from Billy Carroll, then lost it. Picked up at the blue line by Fraser, and he hands it in turn to Billy Carroll. Carroll is checked. Now here's Morrow at center ice. He ran into some traffic, and the puck comes back in deep for Edelbrink. Out to Miner. Miner up the right side, but Langevin stepped in front of Fraser, and that pass didn't go anywhere. Krejci to Billy Carroll. He backhands it into the Vancouver zone. Time running down in the second period. Edelbrink has it back at the net. Edelbrink up the left side for Williams. Williams to Moline. Moline across the line. Checked by Gillies, and McEwen shoots it into the Vancouver zone. Edelbrink hustling after it. Krejci chasing him, but Edelbrink touched it first. That's the icing call with 4:27 left in period two. Ryan Krejci with another assist tonight, giving him 21 in this playoff year. That's goaltender Richard Brodeur at his net, fixing the strap. What happens occasionally, the straps come loose around the skate. The straps that hold the pad anchored to his leg. At this, he can easily trip on them. At this point in the second period, the New York Islanders are out shooting the Vancouver Canucks 13-5. That is in this period alone, 22-13 The shots on goal favor of the Islanders with 4:27 left in the second period. Game four will be Sunday night. You'll see it live on Channel 9 beginning at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. And you're right here at the Pacific Coliseum, Sunday night at 8. Jake McDonald, Ed Westfall with you as McEwen feeds it up the left side off the stick of Bourne. Backing up was the rookie defenseman Bellin, and he dumps it into the Islanders zone. That's McEwen with it. Mike McEwen rushed from behind by Williams, and the pass went right to Miner. Now McEwen to Bourne, who'll try to bring it out of there, kicks it into center ice. Bellin has it, gave it to Stepps. Now to Miner. Gary Miner sent Moline over the line. A long shot. Fifth to sixth save. In comes Bellin. McEwen tried to knock it away from him. Now Trache tied up in the corner. Williams centered. Moline turned. Shoots. Fifth to save. Big rebound. A scramble in front. And the Islanders have managed to cover up and force a faceoff. Bill Smith smothering the puck. And now some shoving again. Bob Bourne involved on the Islanders side. Williams is standing there jawing away. I hope he never becomes a broadcaster. We're all in trouble.
Watch what happens here with number 22. Now the play is dead right there. Maybe they'll keep it rolling. Here's the play. Billy Smith has made some great saves here in the second period. You don't see Williams until right there. Now the play is dead. Williams comes in and starts to push his way through the crowd. Elbows stick up high, only trying to generate and intimidate. And that's where all this time is being taken to play the hockey game with moves such as that after the play is dead.
And she knows you. You're waving to you anyway, E.T. 3:44 left in period two.
How nice.
Vancouver makes a late player change. Alenka comes up along with Rota and Sam Spiel. They have Campbell on defense with Lindgren for the Islanders, and it's Trache, Nystrom, and Gore. Rota stepped into the faceoff just as the puck was dropped into the circle, at least, that acts as a restraining area. A pitching matchup for the Mets tomorrow night, Randy Jones against Valenzuela. Potan plays it back at the Islander goal, taken there by Lane. Lane to Goring, unable to clear it out. It's loose in front. This is Rota, turn, and then a weak shot was picked up by Potan. To Trache, down to Nystrom. Nystrom over the Vancouver line. Upended from behind. Lindgren got away with it. And Campbell rushes into center ice. Poked it into the Islander zone, chases it himself. Pumps Lane. Gordy Lane elects to tie it up, but it's game loose. John Tinelli starts out with Goring and Nystrom. Nystrom across the Vancouver line. The pass to Tinelli. Cuts in. Shoots. Look at a spectacular save. Good pass. Nystrom, Tinelli, and Goring. This line clicking. And Radur came up big. Now Hlinka is belted by Popancheck. And Hlinka gets up very slowly. Gord Lane around to John Tinelli. Tinelli dumps it into center ice. Hlinka limps to the Vancouver bench. Campbell slaps it around the Islanders zone. Smith got it out for Potvin, as you see. Kenny Potvin, a nice room that was stolen by Fraser. Kurt Fraser runs into Potvin, knocking him down. The puck is under the Islander captain. And now comes loose for Spiel. Over to Hallward. Hallward, a backhand shot. Smith the save, and he holds on. And with the stick, he'll fend off Fraser as well. There's a break in the action. The score, Islanders 2, Canucks nothing. 2 minutes, 29 seconds remaining in the second period. Ryan Trache on the faceoff against Ivan Boldarev. Gradin shifted to the left side on this line. Fraser on the right. And the puck cleared by Gillies. Right back to Bill Smith. Now to Persson. Stefan Persson to Langevin. Langevin to Gillies to Persson. To Langevin to Brent Sutter. Sutter comes into the center ice zone. Across the Vancouver line, Brent Sutter cuts to the right. The pass to Dwayne Sutter, took it off the boards to Brent. Oh, and his shot was off the crossbar. Brent Sutter picks it up again, trying to move in around Hallward. Sutter was checked, and Brodeur poked it through the corner. There's Brent Sutter to Gillies. Mark Gillies gets away from Hallward, back to Langevin. Langevin shot through a screen. Brodeur the save. They finally pried it loose, and steps into Dwayne Sutter after the whistle. They're going to face off to the right of the Vancouver goal with a minute and 50 seconds remaining in period number two. Ed Westfall has gone down to the dressing room area. He'll have one of the Islanders as a guest at the end of the second period. I'll be talking with Jake Bilford, who will step down this summer as the general manager of the Vancouver Canucks. And his final year has been a great success here. The team that was going nowhere early in the season put it all together late. And here they are in the Stanley Cup Finals for the first time in the 10-year history of the franchise. Richard Rodure, one of the main reasons for that is goaltending was spectacular against Los Angeles in their second series after they had eliminated Calgary three straight. He was spectacular again in the Chicago Blackhawks series. And the Islanders got to him in overtime the other night for a 5-4 win, the first game of the series. Beat him 6-4 at the Coliseum in game two. And tonight they lead 2-0. The puck loose. Here's Gillies moving in. Brodeur, good stick save to take him way up on top of that goal crease. Now Fraser across the Islander line. There's Fraser in deep centered. And Smith and Pearson confers to clear it to the corner. Pearson around the board. Mark Gillies picks it up in the left wing, shot it into center ice. The Canucks had a chance to play it, so Steps will have to go back. No icing. A minute 20 left in the period. Harold Steps up the right side. At center ice, they feed it to Fraser. Fraser over the line, trying to come through the defense. Couldn't do it, and Bossy wheels out. Bossy and Trottier. The pass to Brian Trottier on left wing. A long shot for Rodeur. The pad save. Big rebound. It's cleared by Fraser. Bossy chased into the corner. Steps there as well. Fraser had it stolen by Bossy to board. He shoots. Good stop again by Brodeur. Canucks have left him alone a couple of times, and he has risen to the occasion. Now Fraser fires one off Gord Lane that ends up back at the Islander goal. 45 seconds left in the period. Lane over to Poffin. Lost it. Recovered in time to feed it off the left wing boards to Bourne. Bob Bourne is across the Vancouver line. Played it out over the line to Trottier. Now to Poffin. Danny Poffin fires it wide of Brodeur. He leaves it for Edelbrink. Edelbrink up the middle off Goring stick and went right to Poffin. Poffin played it to the right side and was deflected into the Islander bench. And this came within about a 6-inch distance of hitting Coach Al Arbor. 22 seconds left in period two. Game four, Sunday night, 8 o'clock here on Channel 9. Nystrom, Goring, and Cinelli, the forward line. Poffin and Morrow, the Islander defense. McEwen in the lineup tonight means that Thomas Johnson sets it out, and I think the only reason for that would be the Islanders thinking that it might be a little more physical than it had been in the first two games, but that hasn't been the case. It has been more of a wide-open skating encounter tonight. Rota on the left side has shot the puck into the Islander zone. Smith leaves it for Morrow. Any Morrow to Bob Nystrom, now to Goring. Butch Goring. Back to Nystrom, across the line. Nystrom trying to get around Lindgren. Over to John Tinelli. To Nystrom. At the horn sounds, ending the second period, just as the Islanders had an opportunity to go for the three-goal lead. But in the period, the Islanders come up with 18 shots at Richard Brodeur. The Canucks manage 8 shots at Bill Smith. The Islanders score twice to take this 2-0 lead as we watch the two teams leave the ice here at the Pacific Coliseum. The crowd, which had been very boisterous earlier, has certainly settled down after the goal by Gillies, and especially after Bossy made it 2-0 at the 12:30 mark. So we've come to the end of two periods, and the score is the New York Islanders 2. Vancouver 0-4. Fourth one coming when Morrow went off for interference at 12:41. We're going to get a quick look at the reason the Islanders are up 2-0. With 20 minutes remaining in regulation.
Playing around the goaltender and around each other. Let's have a look now. That's Clark Kelly scoring. Stephon Pearson's shot. This is Mike Bossy as he falls. There's the first shot by Bossy. Rodeur a save. Now watch Bossy. He's going down. He is actually level to the ice. He is horizontal when he made the shot the second time. Bossy is 50 from Tinelli and Trottier at 12:30. Gilly got his 8 at 2:56 from Brent Sutter, making the score 2-0. Big period, swing period, or of course we're in the swing game, as they call it, in a 4-out-of-7 series. Vancouver is going to have to open up the floodgates and go all out. They're going to have to put the pedal to the metal.
And we watch them as Jim Dill dumps the puck into the Islanders' zone, and he's ready to square off with four. Over comes linesman Bob Hodges. Ron Finn grabs four, and Hodges grabs Dill. Referee Van Helman sends them both to the penalty box. 12 seconds into the final period. A collision, then the stick came up, and the challenge was issued, and answered, and we get the penalty.
It's a good move, Jiggs, by the two linesmen. It's a dangerous move in one way, because the players are setting to let fire with a punch the first opening they see. And both linesmen, knowing they had but a half a second, got in between them quickly and dragged them off balance and away from each other, preventing them from getting into a fight. They will probably get 2 minutes apiece, where they may have gotten seven at least.
We'll have 4 minutes and penalties up on the board against the Canucks.
Well, I've been wrong before. And 2 minutes against Bob Bourne. The expression on the youngster's face behind the penalty box said it all as they looked at Bob Bourne a few moments ago. And there is Jim Mill. Scored an overtime goal. Not in this series. Against Chicago.
Mill draws two for high kicking, two for roughing. Bourne 2 minutes for roughing. 12 seconds into the final period. Islanders have outshot the Canucks through two periods, 27-16. And now Roger Nielsen is sending out Schmeel and Gradin as his forwards. Snep and Hallward will be on defense. It'll be Anders Kaller and Billy Carroll up front for the Islanders, with McEwen and Morrow on defense. Carroll on the draw, got control of the puck, then it went to Gradin, back to Hallward. In off the boards for Gradin. Gradin being watched by McEwen, played it to the corner. That's Schmeel with it, back to the point. Hallward held on to it as Carroll fell in front of him. Hallward starts in, chased wide. Goes round behind the net, short side. Sets the third, couldn't play the handle. Gradin's shot went wide, and Smith seemed to lose sight of it. Now comes to the right side. Carroll tipped it to McEwen. To Kaller, to Billy Carroll, one-on-one with Hallward. Carroll around Hallward, went to the backhand, shoots on, he just put it wide by a fraction.
What a move. Play by Billy Carroll.
What a move by Billy. Now Schmeel cuts to the left. Cross the line. They drop it back to Step. He plays it back in the Islander goal, right to McEwen. McEwen to Tonelli, tips it to the left side. Billy Carroll started to chase it, then went to the player's bench, and it's replaced by Goring. Tonelli went into forecheck as the Canucks gave it to Step. Back of the net now to Hallward. Tonelli moved in to try and knock it away from him as he fed it to Boldarev. Boldarev, gypsy doodling in his own zone, plays it to the left side for Hallward. Out over the line it comes into center ice. Moline delighted with his teammate Boldarev. Goring lost his balance and went down, and Langevin moves up to clear the puck. Now shot into the Islanders zone, and Smith leaves it for Langevin. Dave Langevin will be 28 on Saturday. He plays it up the left side. It goes to Bossy. Back to Langevin. Got to go to Lane. 20 seconds left in Bourne's penalty, and then the Islanders, barring further penalties against them, will have a man advantage. This is Langevin. Moline forces him back in the net. Langevin over to Lane. Now to Trache. Went off his stick. Picked up by Moline. His shot turned aside by Smith. Here's Gordy Lane with it. Out of the penalty box comes Bourne as Lane got over the line, fed it to the left side to Bossy. Mike Bossy taken in by Lindgren. Trache picks up the puck. Trache back to Poffin. Poffin from the point, pulled it outside the blue line, shot it back in offside.
The hesitation of Dennis Poffin at the blue line. Just a portion, any portion of the puck outside the blue line, and it's offside. And 48 seconds on the penalty to Jim Nill. The Islanders now go to a power play.
They have changed the scoring on the second Islander goal, the announcement just now being made. They've taken the assist from Tonelli and given it to Stefan Persson. So it now reads Bossy on Trache and Persson, and here's Trache trying to get around Lindgren in the Vancouver zone. Was checked. Bourne picked it up, gave it to Bossy, back to Bourne. Bob Bourne out to Bossy. With a point for Persson to Poffin. Mathan centers, and it was tipped away by Lindgren. Pearson moves up. Couldn't get a stick on it. Gary Lupel has it. And into center ice comes Campbell with a long shot. Smith to save. The puck got away from him. He managed to clear it to Bossy. Minute 15 left in the power play for the Islanders. Pearson lugs it into center ice. Over the Vancouver line, cutting to the right side. Gave it to Clark Gillies. Gillies back to the point. Off the stick of Pearson. Mathan covers up. Islanders 2, Canucks nothing. Poppin to Pearson. Stephen Pearson, long pass to Gillies. Comes over the Vancouver line, a long shot off the stick hand of Brodeur. Gillies, the Bossy, went off the heel of his stick, and Moline slaps one up to the blind, held in by Pearson. To Gillies, Clark Gillies with a shot over the crossbar. Bounces to the left wing boards, and Moline slaps it down the ice. Islanders, Jigs, can't seem to get the power play working together. Brent Sutter just dropped the puck for Poppin. Around Lupo's slash, Poppin comes to the Vancouver line. Tried a shot that bounced off Hallward right to the goaltender, and he holds on. Brent Sutter came in quickly. Nothing happened, but the sticks are up again. And there's Spiel throwing a right. Lupo having some words.
As the Islanders converged on goaltender Richard Brodeur, Brodeur put his stick up in the face of Brent Sutter. This is the thing that Clark Gillies said in the interview at the end of the first period that annoys him most is all of the lip service. Let's play hockey. That's what we're here for. Forget all that nonsense. Let's play hockey.
It was Brent Sutter and Steps who were exchanging words there at the end of it all. We look at Brent Sutter. He's had more ice time tonight than he has had in the last series with Quebec, and this series combined, I would think, and has contributed tonight, setting up the goal by Gillies back in the second period at 2:56. Islanders got the draw to Poppin. Around the boards, that's Brent Sutter chasing it. Ties up Spiel. Dwayne Sutter came over, but it's frozen, and we'll get a face-off, and again, some jostling. And there's Stepp taking a swing at Dwayne Sutter. McEwen and Brent Sutter up against the boards. Lupel and Spiel for the Canucks. We could still be here for a long time at the pace of the third period. We're 4 minutes into it. That's Gary Lupel that you're looking at.
Yeah.
Young, 21 years old, 5'8", 175 pounds, from Powell River, British Columbia. A local boy.
He's seen a little more ice time.
Now the Islanders got the draw. This is Dwayne Sutter into the corner to Brent Sutter, and Steps went after Dwayne Sutter. The referee, Van Helleman, comes over. Let's see if he's got one or two penalties.
He's got two, I'm sure, Jiggs. He had both hands in the air, Van Helleman, when he signaled the penalties. There's a break in the action. The score, the New York Islanders 2, the Vancouver Canucks, nothing. They cannot accuse Dwayne Sutter of picking only on the little guys. Harold snaps with a left hook. There was no penalty on that call. It was the next exchange after the faceoff that got them both roughing penalties.
4:06, the time of the penalties, and you just saw Brodeur come up with another key save for Vancouver. And now Williams takes the shove at Krejci. Krejci tries to skate away from him. He skated right into Campbell. Brodeur was up on top of the goal crease again to make the stop.
Hard shot by Captain Dennis Potvin. As he gets it up high, Brodeur got a hold of it. Campbell was sliding out, trying to block the shot by Potvin. Dennis got it over him. Brodeur made the save.
So we get ready for a face-off to the right of Brodeur. Wayne Barrick centers for John Tinelli and Bob Nystuen. McEwen and Morrow, the Islander defense. Canucks got the draw. Lindgren trying to play it out of his own zone to Delorme now. The center ice. And over the Islander line comes Hlinka. Rota open on the left side. Hlinka fired it wide on the glove side. Campbell around the boards to Rota. R.C. Rota burst into the corner by McEwen's persistent checking. Here's Hlinka with it. Hlinka centered. Delorme can't get it in time. And it's loose at center ice. Here's Tinelli on a breakaway. John Tinelli comes in and he shot it high.
Tough break. John Tinelli on a breakaway.
As he went to shoot the puck, it rolled up on edge. He shot it not over the net, but over the glass. Here goes all alone. John Tinelli in, and the puck, he got it out on the end of the stick. He was looking for the opening behind. Here's Hlinka. Here's Hlinka's shot. He missed the net way wide on the left side. A two-on-one break. Hlinka, who had three shots in the first period, missed the net with that one.
That's good a play, yet not that bad a play on Hlinka's part. He had Rota, but I don't know that he could have got it to him.
He has a chance to use him as a decoy, Jake, is what he does. But it's no good if he does not hit the net. There he is. Ivan Hlinka from Most, M-O-S-T, Most, Czechoslovakia. Sing song, do you know what they're saying?
No, I didn't pick up on it. Sounds like we're in Quebec. Howard checked back of the goal by Tinelli and recovered the puck. Tinelli bumped into him, took it away from him, gave it to Merrick, to Nystrom, and another great save by Brodeur off Nystrom. Out comes Rota. Archie Rota across the Allender line, dropped it to Boldarev, his shot right on. Smith juggled it, then held on, and we'll get a faceoff. Delore back to the whistle, knocked Smith down. Tinelli was off balance to begin with, and they converge in front of the Islander net. Islanders with three shots in this period, the Canucks with three. All the scoring came in period number two.
Billy Smith paying attention to his neck, doing an excellent, an outstanding job. As you see the shot, Ivan Boldarev, the shot gets away from Smith. He gets up. There's a little extra from behind by Schmeel. Here's the play at the other end. Good stop by Brodeur off Bob Nystrom, who got the shot away in fine fashion. Brodeur again making the save. 30 shots by the Islanders in the game so far. 20 by Vancouver.
We have 14 minutes and 52 seconds remaining in regulation time. Friday night at 8 on Channel 9. 8 o'clock New York time, New York Mets baseball. Randy Jones for the Mets, Fernando Valenzuela for the Los Angeles Dodgers. We'll be live from Shea Stadium Friday night at 8. McEwen was checked in the corner. Moline shot hit Morrow in front of the net, and now McEwen plays it to Trache, to Nystrom. Nystrom into center ice, over to Wayne Merrick. He's across the Vancouver line, trying to come in around Campbell, gave it to Nystrom. Nystrom turning, set up by Hallward, and there's Moline for Vancouver. Moline lugs it into center ice. Over the Allender line, a long shot off the skate of Bill Smith. It came loose and launched and covered up. Good skate save, turning the left leg. It goes all the way down into the Vancouver zone, and this will be called for icing. 14:06 left in regulation time. The score, the Islanders 2, the Canucks nothing. Face off in the Islanders zone as you see Fraser take Pearson into the boards. Langevin from back of the net, fed it to Clark Gilley. To Trottier. Trottier came to center, dumped it in, and then is replaced by Kaller. It is Kaller, Brent Sutter, and Clark Gilley. Gilley runs into a heavy check. Brent Sutter gave the puck to Kaller, but he couldn't find the handle. On his left side, Gradin gets into the Islanders zone to Fraser, and is shot off the stick hand of Bill Smith. Pearson belted as he played it around the boards. Moline to Fraser, back of the net. Pearson tied him up, and Brent Sutter went to clear one that was deflected and right back to Pearson. To Gillies, to Brent Sutter. Sutter left it for Kaller. Anders Kaller chased to the corner, trying to get away from Hallward. The puck went loose. Lindgren picks it up, and Kaller knocks him down. Brent Sutter has it. Brent Sutter tried to set up board, and that was blocked by Hallward. Here's Anders Kaller now as he grabbed, tackled on the board by Lindgren, and the Canucks clear one to center ice for Gradin. He's over the line. Gradin went to the backhand, turned, Canucks in the middle of a player change, and Gradin handed it right to Pearson. Gave it to Brent Sutter. Launched it without a stick as Brent Sutter passed it out of the reach of Bourne, and the Canucks chase it into their own zone, and it's going to be called for icing.
Dave Langevin loses his stick. He can't get to the bench. They decide the best thing to do is ice the puck. Don't take a chance. It's a good play. They'll take a chance on the faceoff rather than having Vancouver get an opportunity with an Islander defenseman without a goal stick. So
saw the fast thinking of Ken Morrow. In the first period, Jake, he didn't have a chance to point it out. Billy Smith lost his stick. Ken Morrow handed him his stick, played defense without a stick, making sure that Smith has a stick, which is more important. Not so much to stop the puck with that skinny little thing that he's not used to holding, but in case he has a chance to control it or shoot it down the ice.
Now Bossy has cleared the puck to Trotche. And from center ice, he tests Rodeur with a long shot. Glove saved and dropped off for Steph. Steph using the boards, but it went right to Poppin. A shot that eluded Rodeur and went wide. Comes back on the far side. Voldarev managed to get it to Jim Neal. Dropped it for Steph to Neal. Neal is over the line with a shot that went wide. Smith clears it to the corner. Tiger Williams and Lane bust together as Trotche came away in control of the puck. Got it to Poppin. Now to Bossy. Backhands it up the right wing side. Lane chases it. Steps was back on the Vancouver defense. Islanders in the middle of the player change. Steps sends Neal into center ice. Williams trailing him. Jim Neal trying to come in around Lane. Center. The puck man steps in front of Williams to break up that play. Don Tinelli has cleared it down into the Canucks zone. Not far enough or fast enough for icing as it turns out. There is Steps using the boards to play it to Tiger Williams. Nystrom slams into him. Williams came away with the puck. Gave it to Bellin. The rookie defenseman got it to Spiel, cuts to the left over the Islander line, then left it outside the line. Here's Nystrom shooting it into the Vancouver zone. Rodeur held it up for Lindgren. Off the boards to Hlinka, then off his stick. Cleared back by Morrow to Nystrom, checked right at the blue line. Hlinka plays it to Bellin. Bellin to Rota, couldn't catch up with it. Hlinka kicked it in on a delayed offside. The Islanders move it out. McEwen to Cinelli, that failed to click. Nystrom chases it. The goaltender, Brodeur, forced to play it. Got it to the near board. Nystrom back to McEwen. Over to Nystrom. Nystrom checked by Lindgren, and it comes out to center ice. There's McEwen back. McEwen to Merrick. Merrick sends Cinelli over the line on left wing. Cinelli tried to set up Nystrom. It was broken up and cleared by Lars Lindgren.
Checking, getting a little closer now, Jake. Vancouver are going to start to feel the pinch as the clock winds below the halfway mark.
10:45 left in regulation time, 2-0 Islanders. Darcy Rota was checked at center ice. Hlinka picks up the puck. Ivan Hlinka across the Islander line with Rota, and the play broken up and cleared neatly by the Islanders. Chasing it is Hallward. Doug Hallward to Moline, couldn't make contact with it. Pearson waits for Wayne Sutter to get back onside before dumping it in. Gillies in after it. He was checked. Wayne Sutter and Fraser go to the corner. Brent Sutter comes over. A pile up. The puck still loose. They rule. It's in the skates of Brent Sutter. He's trying to kick it back to Gillies. Couldn't do it, and we'll get a face-off. And we'll get a little more shoving and pushing along the board. Wayne Sutter draws the attention of the Vancouver Canucks. 10:09 remaining in regulation time. There was a break in the action. The score is the New York Islanders 2, the Vancouver Canucks.
That is right next door, the Vancouver box. Jake Milford, that Jake McDonald just talked to, and closer to you, Harry Neal. On the far side, Jack Gordon, one-time general manager of the Minnesota North Stars, now connected here with and scouting for Vancouver.
The other man in the box with them, Larry Propine, formerly with the Rangers, then with Vancouver as their scout for a long time. Now Moline into center ice, gave it to Fraser, comes to the Islander line, handed it right to Langevin. Dave Langevin up the left side to Clark Gillies. His pass intercepted, Moline shot one off Langevin and comes out to center ice. Campbell comes together with Wayne Sutter in a heavy collision. Moline checked at the Vancouver line, now gets it back for Doug Hallward. Hallward at center, shot one in off the glass, it came through in front of the net, cleared by Smith, held in by the Canucks. This is Gradin, a centering attempt hit Carroll. Gradin went to center it again, and this time cleared by Pearson. Moline tied up by Billy Carroll, and there is Langevin. Langevin went to shoot it around the boards and hit Fraser. Now Langevin gets it to Wayne Sutter, and he dumps it down into the Vancouver zone. This will be an icing call against the Islanders. We have 9:06 left in regulation. Wayne Sutter going to the bench. He again draws the attention of the Canucks. Fraser wanted to go after him. As we look at William Smith.
He's cool tonight. He has put the stop on all of the shooters of Vancouver. standing on his feet as we look at some of the action. That's Colin Campbell and Dwayne Sutter. There's a little extra, another extra shot by Campbell. Sutter and Campbell giving it a second dimension.
A lot of Sutters here tonight.
The Twins were in the hotel when we checked in today.
They'll go high in this summer's National Hockey League entry draft. Rich and Ron, the last of the Sutter brothers. Now Lane has cleared the puck in his own zone to John Tinelli, dumped it into center ice. That's Bellin. Bellin backhanding it into the Islanders zone. Poppin chases it. Kenny Poppin up at the side of the net, but he managed to play it off the boards for John Tinelli. Tinelli's pass for Carroll was blocked. Here's Poppin with it at center ice. He was checked. Tinelli is there. Tinelli rink wide to Kaller, lost it to Bolderev. Bolderev checked from behind by Kaller. And yelling again. Here's Gord Lane up to Kaller across the Vancouver line. Anders Kaller chased to the corner by Steps, put it out in front. Billy Carroll turned, but Brodeur had made sure that his teammate Bolderev was in a position to pick it up. And he played a long pass to Williams. Tiger Williams checked by Morrow. They go to the corner together. Williams plays it off the boards, and that's Billy Carroll with it back of the net. To Morrow. Now to Kaller. Kaller slapped it to the line. It hit Carroll as Edelbrink went to shoot it in and comes out into center ice. Now fired in. Bill Smith plays it for Bob Bourne. To Mike McEwen. 7:40 remaining in regulation time. Islanders lead it 2-0, and again Edelbrink forces the Islanders to go back. In this period, the Islanders with only 3 shots on goal. The Canucks have had 6, but the Islanders in control of it. Kaller is across the blue line. Kaller to Trache went off his stick, picked it up again, shot for and tipped it right on, and another save by goaltender Brodeur. A break in the action. The score, Islanders 2, Canucks nothing. Well, the 16,413 on hand haven't gotten a whole lot of use out of those towels tonight. McEwen shot one in from the left point. It's cleared around the boards by Edelbrink. Lindgren with it. Off the boards to Gary Lupo. Over to Edelbrink. Edelbrink to the Allender line. Went to shoot it into the corner, but then hesitated and put his team offside.
Schmeel on the left side as Edelbrink stick handles with the puck at the blue line, creating the offside. The Islanders would like to see the fans using the towels to cry in, I'm sure.
Well, it's looking that way with 7:07 left in regulation. Joe, the thought comes to mind, Ed. The series playing Tuesday and Thursday, and then having Friday and Saturday off before resuming Sunday. Why not play Friday and Sunday?
I'm 2 days for travel. As we look at the play a moment ago, as Bob Bourne tipped a shot from Brian Crutche. It was a pass, actually. Bourne tipped it. Brodeur, from close in, made a fine save.
I think I just heard somebody say it is Friday. In New York it is, yes, 25-1.
It would probably make a little bit more sense, Jiggs. I favor having the games a little closer together. Even as a player, I think you appreciate the games a little closer together.
Close call at the side of the Islander goal as the puck was deflected. Now Gillies has dumped it into center, into the Canuck territory. That'll bring back. It didn't go far enough for icing. Picked up by Dwayne Sutter to Brent Sutter. Can't sneak back to the net. Williams tied him up. Edelbrink moved it ahead to Bolderev. Bill cuts to the left. Bolderev at the Islander line, waited outside and couldn't make the play. Langevin tips it to the Vancouver territory. The reason there isn't a game here Saturday night is due to a rock concert that couldn't be changed. Now Campbell from the left point had his shot blocked by Pearson, and Brent Sutter feeds it to Clark Gillies. Gillies shoots the puck wide to the Canuck goal. Campbell back, slapped it off the boards right to Pearson, but it hopped over to his stick. There's to Langevin. Dave Langevin to Nystrom. Islanders controlling the game at both ends of the ice. 5:50 remaining in regulation. They lead it 2-0. A chance to take a stranglehold on the series with a victory here tonight. This is Campbell across the Islander line. Colin Campbell's shot. He's tipped up in the air and tipped away from the side of the net by Smith to Nystrom. Nystrom at center, 3-on-2, across the line, gave it to Tinelli. Tinelli has shot. That's put wide of the Vancouver goal, comes up the left wing, and here's Spiel with it. Dan Spiel facing Lane as he came in over the line. Spiel with a backhand shot that was way wide. John Tinelli picks it off the board, fed it to Goring. Nystrom cuts down the right wing, now shifts to the left side. Goring comes over the line, shoots one. That hits steps and ends up in the seats. A break in the action, 5:09 left in regulation time. Our score, New York Islanders leading the Canucks 2-0. It was game four in Quebec when the fans were all but ready to leave and their team scored two goals to bring everybody back to their seats. The fans here trying to rally, get their team going. They trying to get behind them to get a goal and get their team on top of the game. Now Harold steps, stopped the boards, Lane got a stick on it at the Allender line, and Steph ends up shooting one around the board. Smith cut it off for Denny Poppin. Poppin up the middle, the pass went off Krotje. Bellin has it at the Vancouver line, giving it to Steph. Backing in deep, being chased by Bourne. That'll force Steph to go back of the net. And now he starts up. Harold Steph played it to center ice. Fraser, right wing pass, stolen, and Poppin forces the Canucks to chase it once more. We're down to 4 minutes and 20 seconds left in regulation time. 2-0 Islander lead. Steps got it to the New York Islander line. It was in the skates of Morrow. Came back to Steps, and he shoots it into the corner. It'll be picked up there by Mike McKillen. Fraser came in to forecheck. McKillen up the right side. Wayne Sutter for the Islanders. Long pass to Gillies on left wing. To Brent Sutter, he's got a breakaway. Cutting in on Brodeur. Pulls it, shoots and hit the goal post. Went to the backhand and put it off the post. From the left point, McKillen left it around the boards and it hit referee Andy Van Halen. Fraser lunged it over the Islander line. Kurt Fraser stopped. And it poked off his stick. Head'll break down. To Fraser at the side of the net, it went off his stick, and Brent Sutter was there. Brent Sutter and Fraser end up in the corner. McKillen comes in as well, and there is no further play.
The pace is starting to tell on the players. It started to tell just after the halfway mark of the third period. The shifts are getting shorter. The players are running out of gas after 30 seconds on the ice. They have kept it up for almost all of this hockey game, an entertaining hockey game. Well skated, a lot of hard hitting. And that man, Mr. Cool tonight, his pads are not wet. He has stood up all night. The only time he's been down is to smother hockey pucks. He challenged every shooter that's been around him 22 times in this hockey game. Vancouver have had shots at him. Not necessarily all good ones, but he has handled them all.
Krotje on the draw, came back to the point. Edelbrink shot. He broke his stick. Part of the stick with the black tape went one way. The puck went the other. And Bill Smith hung with the puck, and out comes Goring. Then Krotje across the line. Tried to feed it through to Nystrom. Nystrom down the corner. Chased by Edelbrink. The puck is loose. Picked up by Bolderev. Stolen by Goring. Butch Goring anticipating well, then he is checked in turn by Jim Nill. At center ice, Lindgren unable to feed it to Bolderev. John Tinelli comes over the line with Goring. Tinelli to Goring, and that was tipped and knocked out of the air with a high stick.
Close call. A gamble by Vancouver comes close to backfiring. The Islanders have a 2-on-1 break. Goring and Nystrom, but Nill's stick gets in the way. It's a high stick. Ending the play. This is Brent Sutter's breakaway as he goes to the backhand. Watch the goalpost right there. You see the puck. He had him beat. Brodeur was down. He had room to get the puck in. There he is on the bench. A little upset with himself. Had a good opportunity. Rung it off the goalpost. The puck started to roll on him a little bit. Just as he took the backhand shot. I don't know what that was. I have to admit.
Butch Goring waiting for the face-off, and then the Vancouver center Hlinka skated away from the face-off, came to the bench. He has a problem with his skate, apparently. So Gradin comes out to take the draw.
Fans get things going again. 3 minutes remaining in the hockey game.
Now here is Spiel starting out. Fired it off the stick of Blanchevin. It bounced right to Bill Smith, and he'll smother it and hold on. Then he got a little spray off the skates of Spiel as he stopped quickly in front of the net.
They're not going to get to Billy Smith tonight. They spray snow in his face, give him the stick, bump into him,
They cannot break. Watch right there as Neil comes in. A shower of snow. Actually, Billy Smith is saying thank you very much. He's very warm, obviously, and behind the map. You see the snow dropping off him. That's kind of a refreshing blast, like the Montreal Express coming at you on a hot day on Long Island.
Thanks, I needed that. 31-22 are the shots on goal in favor of the Islanders, and they lead 2-0 with a little less than 3 minutes to play in regulation time. The puck has been dumped down into the Vancouver zone, was rolling on edge when Hallward picked it up, and then Trotche took the feet out from under Doug Hallward. Alenka up the right wing side. Neal to Darcy Rota. Rota over the line. Checked by Pearson. They go to the board. Fossey tried to clear it out. Rota missed it. Struggles for it, and finally the whistle sounds. We're going to face off. Pearson was down. The puck was actually loose, but it was out of the sight of referee Van Helleman. Have to start thinking now about timeouts, pulling goaltenders, defensive action. What do we do if we're in our end of the ice? The Islanders say we know what the game plan is. We've done it so many times before. With Vancouver, 2 minutes and 26 seconds remaining, down two. They've got to get some shots at Billy Smith, and they have not been able to do too many. Something they have not been able to do too many times here in the third period. Islanders had been outscored 5-2 in the second periods in the first two games. Canucks had outscored them 5-2. Right, both Islander goals came in the middle period. We watch Moline trying to center. It's loose at the side and then covered up by Pearson and Bill Smith.
The thing the Islanders do not want to do, Jake, is try and kill off the 2 minutes and 14 seconds in their own end of the ice. They're too smart for that. They have too much experience. That's what the talk on the dressing on the players' bench will be. Let's get the draw, get the puck down to their end of the ice, so they can't get Brodeur out of the net.
That was one of the funniest quotes out of the Quebec-Montreal series that I heard or read. Quebec said they played the period. Oh, we'll get to that. Here's Trotche across the line with Gillies. The pass broken up and cleared outside the blue line. The Nordiques said they played the period in their end of the ice on purpose because it cut down on the breakaways and the two-on-ones against.
All right, we tired them out in our own end of the ice.
Yeah. 2 minutes and 2 seconds remaining in regulation time as you look at Al Arbor and the New York Islander bench, and now it's Wayne Sutter. That is Dennis Potvin. Has not given up on their Canucks. And you know that Sunday night they're going to be flying with a couple of days rest, the home crowd behind them and their backs to the wall. There's the cliche, you knew I'd get it in. It'll be a battle here, battle royal come Sunday. Game four. Lord Lane from the Vancouver line. His shot was blocked. Thomas Verdeen with a minute 35 left in the game. Brings it to center ice. Shot it wide of the Islander net. Brodeur has gone to the bench, a shot off the board. Smith had to cover up. Steel got one away, and now Fraser turns quickly and sprays Billy Smith with snow.
More air conditioning for Billy Smith as he goes down one of the few times, but just to freeze the puck. More words by Vancouver and the New York Islanders. The folks are on their feet with their towels. They're not ready to use them to cry with yet. They want their team to get a goal. A minute and 29 seconds. Faceoff is going to be in the Islanders' end after this timeout called Vancouver. Roger Nielsen calling a timeout to go over once again the strategy of trying to get two goals in a minute and 29 seconds against Billy Smith and the New York Islanders.
Tomorrow night, or tonight as it is now, Eastern Time, New York Mets baseball on Channel 9, 8 o'clock from Shea Stadium. The pitching matchup is Randy Jones, the Mets, against Fernando Valenzuela, the Los Angeles Dodgers. Mets beat the Dodgers 4-2 tonight, has run their win streak to 4 in a row. Could have been 5 except for the rains last night. They're leading San Diego 3-1 at the top of the fifth, one away, and the game was called. Goring, Nystrom, Morrow, and Potvin for the Islanders. Volderev will take the face-off. Steele, Verdeen, and Fraser, the rest of the forwards.
drafted as Lars Colleen, a forward. They go with five forwards. Hallward, the lone defenseman. Strache on the draw, comes back to the point. Hallward shot blocked, cleared by Morrow, to Goring, to Nystrom, and he's got an empty net. Bobby Nystrom will cap it off, and it is 3-0 Islanders with a minute and 20 seconds still to play.
So often it does not work. The gamble backfires, but you have to take it anyway. It's a percentage gamble, down 2-0. Bob Nystrom gets the pass, goes in all alone on the empty net, and makes it 3-0. So easy. There's the pass by Butch Goring. And Nystrom races in on the emptiness of the net. You see the puck in it.
And you know the Bob's mom and dad are here tonight. He grew up in this area. That is his fifth playoff goal, coming into an empty net at 18:40.
The only goal so far of the third period. Goring from the faceoff. A neat pass to Bobby Nystrom, and it's in 3-0.
Now Potvin has dumped it into the Canuck zone. Brodeur, the steps. Harold Snepp put it right on the stick of Goring. He had trouble picking it up. Tinelli seals it. Dumped it into the corner, but back comes Harold Snepp. Snepp with 62 seconds left in regulation time is cleared at the center, and that's Morrow for Potvin. Danny Potvin's pass intercepted by Dan Spiel to Snepp. Snepp gets over the line, went to pass one, and came off Morrow's skate. So Mike Fallon backs up to the Vancouver line. Gave it to Harold Snepp. Snepp's forcing the Islanders to chase it. 40 seconds remaining. Here's Potvin to Dwayne Sutter. Cleared it out over the blue line to center ice. Ron DeLorme has it there. Now Morrow shoots it into the center ice zone.
Boulder have ahead. Morrow to Gilly. 20 seconds remaining.
He has flipped it high in the Vancouver zone. Snepp's back of the goal for Lindgren. Up to Ron DeLorme. Gilly's knocked it off his stick. We have 10 seconds left. And it ends up inside the Islanders' zone. Their side, the Gilly. And Billy Smith has shut out Vancouver Canucks as the game comes to a close. It is his third playoff shutout. He had won in the 79-80 march to the Stanley Cup. One in 78-79, and tonight here at the Pacific Coliseum, he shuts up the Vancouver Canucks for the first time in his career, either playoffs or a lifetime. Al Arbor and the Islanders, heading for their dressing room, lead the series by the same score as tonight's game ended up, 3-0. Islanders in charge with one game left here in Vancouver on this two-game trip. The series, should it be extended, would go to the Nassau Coliseum next Tuesday. If it goes six games, we'll be back here a week from tonight, at least tonight when the game started. And should it be extended to the full seven, it would be concluded at the Nassau Coliseum on Saturday, May 22nd. But the Islanders have won it 3-0. We'll be back with a recap and the Budweiser star of the game selection following this message.